Welcome to Bharatvansh YouTube channel. Please do like, comment, share and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon for more updates.
The Mahamegavahana dynasty was an ancient ruling dynasty of Kalinga after the decline of Maurya Empire. The dynasty is also known as the Chedi, Cheta or Chetavansha. The history of the earlier kings of the Cheta dynasty during the reign of Ashoka is not known. The label Mahamegavahana means the Lord of the Great Clouds, who uses the clouds as his vehicle. It may mean that the kings were as powerful as Indra. The dynasty also carries another name for it, namely Aira. During the period of Ashoka, he had appointed a member of Chedi family to govern the South Kosala region, presently the Chhattisgarh state. After the death of Ashoka, they might have shifted their seat of power from the original Chedi Rashtra to Kalinga. Decline of Mauryan power encouraged the governors to become independent rulers and establish their own dynasty. Mahamegavahana, 185 BC to 160 BC. He was the first independent ruler who established the dynasty at Kalinga. He became independent from the weak Mauryan rulers and conquered entire Kosala region. Vridharaja, 160 BC to 145 BC. Second ruler of the dynasty and son of Mahamegavahana. He was mentioned as Cheti Raja in Hathi Gumpa inscription. His son was a great warrior king in Indian history. Kharavela, 145 BC to 132 BC. Son of Vridharaja and grandson of Mahamegavahana. During his reign, South Kosala became an integral part of the kingdom. He patronized Jainism but did not discriminate against other religions. He was a contemporary of Satakarni of Satavahana dynasty and Pushyamitra of Shunga dynasty. He sent an army with cavalry, elephants and chariots to defeat Satakarni I in his initial years. Kharavela subdued the Rashtrika and Bhojaka kings who were vassals of Satavahana dynasty. Kharavela challenged a Yavana ruler, Menander I, who had killed another king and proceeded till Magadha. The ruler was pushed beyond Mathura. Kharavela is famous in the history of Kalinga and of India as a mighty monarch. He belonged to the third generation of Kalinga Chedi dynasty. It was under him that Kalinga became a great power with extensive territories as an empire. The life and achievements of Kharavela are vividly known from his famous Hathi Gumpha inscription. Kharavela was crowned king of Kalinga at the age of 24 years. The Hathi Gumpha inscription describes the first 13 years of his reign. According to Hathi Gumpha inscription, Kharavela repaired gates and buildings that had been damaged by storms, built reservoirs and tanks, and restored the gardens during his first year of accession. He organized musical concerts, entertained the city with festive gatherings which included singing, dancing and instrumental music. Kharavela commissioned waterworks involving a canal originally built by Nanda rulers. Rajasuya Yaga and Expansion. He sent out an expedition to conquer Bharatavarsha during which he performed the Rajasuya Yaga. He cancelled taxes because of obtained wealth from the kings he attacked. Kharavela built a settlement of masons and exempted its land revenue because of the wealth brought home of Anga and Magadha. He subdued the Pandya king and his confederacy of Tamil kingdoms which had been threatening Kalinga. He also built an enclosure for elephants, horses by the wealth collected from the Pandya king. Kharavela made the king of Magadha bow at his feet. Brihaspati Mitra was the king of Kaushambi and his rule might have extended to Magadha as well. Kharavela brought back an idol of Agrajina, possibly of Rishabhanatha, which had been taken to Magadha during the reign of Mahapadmananda. Kharavela is mentioned as Bhikshu Raja, the king of monks, a devotee of all sects, the possessor of an invincible army and an illustrious king. he did some Jain religious ceremony near the Arhat temple on the Kumari hill by organizing scholars and ascetics. He erected pillars of Vaidurya Garbha in Patalaka and Chetaka caves. Kharavela donated Kalpavriksha, horses, elephants, chariots, houses and other gifts to Brahmins and built a new palace. When his wife Dusi or Vajira Gharavati gave birth to a son, his successor. His queen was granddaughter of Hastisiha Mahamatra of Mauryan Empire and daughter of Lalaka. She had a strong and leadership personality. Vajira Gharavati assisted her husband in state affairs and administered the kingdom during his absence due to battles and wars. Kharavela's second wife was Sindhula, a Jain follower who encouraged him to donate generously towards Jain deeds. Kharavela's empire is believed to have disintegrated soon after his death. Vakradeva, 132 BC to 120 BC. He is also known as Kudepa Siri or Vakadipa. He was Kharavela's son and successor. His inscription is found in Udayagiri and he had the same titles as Kharavela, Kalingadipati and Mahameghavahana. Vaduka, 120 BC to 100 BC. He is son of Vakradeva. Galavya, 100 BC. Probably the last ruler of the main dynasty. The Kalinga kingdom was defeated by the ruler of Satavahana dynasty during his reign. Later, in 2nd century, during the reign of Gautamiputra Satakarni, the kingdom was annexed by Satavahanas. Architecture of the dynasty. Udayagiri and Khandagiri caves are the most prominent architectural examples of Mahameghavahana dynasty. Both were built during the reign of Kharavela in 2nd century BC. The Hathi Gumpha and Ganesha Gumpha inscriptions at Udayagiri provide the historical records of the dynasty. The Rani Ka Nor and Ananta Cave are also examples of the dynasty's marvelous architecture. After the capture of Kalinga by Satavahanas, the royal family members moved to different parts of the kingdom and established small kingdoms of their own. Magha or Megha dynasty of Kosambi or Kosala and Sada dynasty of coastal Andhra claim their ancestry to the Mahameghavahana dynasty and Kharavela. Magha dynasty, 106 to 350 CE. Bhimasena, 106 to 130 CE. He is also called as Vasishthiputra Bhimasena. His ancestors were probably feudatories of Kanishka of Kushan dynasty, and he founded the principality in the jungles near Rewa in Madhya Pradesh. He ruled independently where Kushan's power did not penetrate. He was a contemporary of Huvishka, the ruler of Kushans, and Gautamiputra Satakarni, the Satavahana king. Shiva Magha, 130 CE to 155 CE. He is also called as Gautamiputra Shiva Magha. He extended his kingdom and ruled Kosala with Bandhogarh regions. Historical records of himself and his ancestor can be obtained from the Bandhogarh inscription and coins issued by him. Prausthasri, 155 CE to 168 CE. He was the eldest son of Shiva Magha and called as Kaushtiputra Prausthasri. The war of succession between brothers resulted in his rule over the southern part of the kingdom, namely Bandhogarh. His younger brother Kaushtiputra Bhadramaga ruled the Kosala region. Bhadradeva, 168 CE to 185 CE. He was the son of Prausthasri and ruled Bandhogarh. During his later period, the two branches were united together. Vaishravana, 185 CE to 210 CE. He was the son of Bhadradeva. The successors of Vaishravana ruled the kingdom independently but without any memorable event. Bhimavarman, son of Vaishravana, Satamagha, son of Bhimavarman. Vijayamagha was son of Satamagha. He was contemporary of Chandragupta I of Gupta dynasty. During his reign, the kingdom was attacked many times by Nagas of Padmavati, who rose to power in Kosala region. Mahendra was son of Vijayamagha. He was defeated by and surrendered to Samudragupta in 350 CE. He was then made a governor of Arang region in Madhya Pradesh. He was the last ruler of Magha dynasty as his ancestral kingdom was annexed to Gupta Empire. Satha dynasty, 20 BC to 100 CE. The rulers of this dynasty ruled as feudatories of Satavahanas. The kingdom was a small land, namely Mahishaka, inside the vast Satavahana Empire. The coins issued by the rulers are the only historical records to know about the dynasty and rulers. Finally, it was annexed to Satavahana kingdom during the reign of Vasishthiputra Pulumavi.
Please like, share, comment and subscribe to Bharatvansh channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon.